And now please join us for Home Delivery Plus Linger Longer, a masterclass with Janae Bridges and Alexandria Crichlow. It's a collaboration with CAAPA, the Coalition of African Americans in the Performing Arts, whose motto is bringing color to the classics. But first, please welcome CAAPA's Executive Director, Terry Allen.
Thank you so much. My name is Pamela Simonson, and I'm co-founder of the Coalition for African Americans in the Performing Arts, better known as CAAPA.
And I'm Terry Allen. I serve as the executive director for CAAPA. Here we support Black classical musicians, youth, and others in the performing arts by
bringing color to the classics.
We'd like to take this opportunity to thank the Washington Performing Arts for allowing us an opportunity to present one of our masterclass series.
Our music master for today is mezzo-soprano Janae Bridges, accompanied by Dr. Lester Green and featuring an emerging soprano named Alexandria Crichlow.
We are so excited to be able to feature the masterclass. It's one of our programs. We have a five-point initiative, the CAAPA Cause. If you think of our acronym, C-A-A-P-A, that stands for Community Outreach, Arts Education, Audience Development, Performance Opportunities, and Arts Partnerships. We also have the masterclass that runs throughout the year, and we hope that you join us on one of those future, where we partner with historically Black colleges and universities, HBCUs. And again, thank you for helping us to
bring color to the classics.
Hello, my name is Alexandria Crichlow, and I will be performing O Mio Babbino Caro from John Ischicchi by Giacomo Puccini. It is an honor and joy to do this masterclass, and since it's Women's Month, you know, all of the things that you represent is huge for me, and I'm so happy to be here.
Brava!
Thank you.
Absolutely beautiful. This aria, there are a few arias that I wish I were a soprano for, and this is one of them. Absolutely stunning. Okay. So I would love for you to tell me and tell us what is going on in this aria.
Sure. So Loretta, I am Loretta, and right now she's in love with Runicchio, and unfortunately, Janiskiki, her father, does not want them to be together, and right now she's convincing her father to let her go to Ponte Rosa to buy herself a ring, and she's in need of being in love with Runicchio. So if she does not have him, she will not be happy, and she will throw herself into the Arno River if she is not. So dramatic. I love
it. So dramatic. Is this opera or something? Oh my goodness.
Right.
Wonderful. Okay, thank you for that. So this is a plea.
Yes.
And she's definitely begging her father for something. So with that said, I would love for you to give me more of that. I feel that you have more of that intention, and you can go there. What I like to do is start and stop. So if you don't mind, we'll just start from the beginning, and it'll be a mixture of intention and also just some vocal suggestions. Okay. And I want you to know that I'm learning myself too. So I've already learned from you by watching and listening to you. And that's what's so amazing about being a singer is it's a never-ending learning process. With that said, I also just want you to know that what I have to say is merely a suggestion. And if it resonates with you, then take it. And if it doesn't, then throw it out. It is okay. Let's start it again, and then we'll go from there. Only because, so there was a really long pause before you came in, but I think that you have to lead this. Or maybe, maybe in the orchestra you're together and it's kind of difficult right now. So what Lester is going to need is a breath. Okay. Or like a pickup or something.
Okay.
And what I actually noticed, I want to talk about breath just a little bit, is I feel that you could have actually taken a more substantial breath.
Okay.
Because I didn't really see any of this move. So let's do that again. And I have a few breath exercises. Actually, one of them is pretending like you have a straw. I usually bring my straws, I'm sorry, but like you have a straw and sipping through the straw. And you can feel your ribs expand. Just do that right now.
Yeah.
Do you feel that?
Immediately, yeah.
And so because you have, you're starting on an O, which is, you know, a beautiful vowel, you want your body to engage and your chords to come together. So rather than, oh, because I hear a little H, oh, don't be afraid to, oh, oh, you know, you hear that? Like
yes.
The chords coming together.
Okay.
And a lot of people feel, oh gosh, you can't glottal, but glottals are actually okay.
Right.
It's just a matter of doing them safely. So, oh, mio babbino. And then you're right on the breath rather than expending the breath before you even sing.
Okay.
You know, by singing homie or not really fully coming together.
Okay.
So let's try that. Let's start it again with that thought in mind. Gosh, your high note was just like no tension. That was gorgeous, gorgeous. I feel like you can use your air.
Okay.
I kind of hear that the the flow of air is stopping, as in a little bit of straight toning.
Okay.
But really sing with vibrato, but don't, you know, we're not here to focus on vibrato, but when I hear that straight tone, it just lets me know that your air is not really flowing.
Okay.
Like it should. So I want you to rock back and forth. And that helps you. Oh, and actually what is really going to is if you do this while you're singing.
Okay.
Oh, mio babbino caro. And if you stop doing that, that tells you, it's an indicator that your air is actually not
moving.
Your air is stopping.
Okay.
Yeah. So one more time. But that start was much better.
Okay.
Yeah. That was already so much more connected. Now I felt you go back to your old ways on. You just kind of straight toned. And I understand, like, you can use straight tone for a color, but because you are really pleading and begging for him, mm-hmm. I think you should just sing.
Okay.
Just sing it. Don't be super artsy, because what Puccini has written is already just like so. Ah. Sorry to stop you right before your high note. This is already so much more connected. Now, I would love, I mean, there's so much juicy Italian and poetry in this. I need you to double, to pay attention to these doubles. L'anello. Like, these are actually beautiful to sing, too. L'anello, CC. And you carried the CC over, but there are commas here. Si, si, ci voglio andare. So I think pay attention to that.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Oh my gosh, just see, by using the language, it already makes it come that much more alive. And with Italian, it's such a glorious language to sing in, because these doublings, they really influence the breath.
Yeah.
You know, and so I just by paying attention to those, I already felt that you were more legato and your breath was just more connected. I feel like your ah vowels can be a little bit brighter.
Okay.
I don't know what language you're used to or what your teacher uses. Brighter, more forward. I mean, it's a very sensitive thing, but I just felt like it was a little bit too. Everything else was so clear, and then I lost ma per buttarmi narno. Like it kind of went back.
Okay.
Your high notes are just so glorious, and I feel mi struggo e mi tormento. Oh, Dio. Like I know that Puccini wrote what he wrote, but he gives us a double piano on the oddio. I mean, it's just like, oh God,
yeah,
I want to die, you know.
Right.
So, in your mind, like quadruple that D.
Okay.
And I don't know if you do this, but it's something that I do. I like to put myself into every character that I sing, and actually every song, and ask myself, okay, what would Janae do in this moment? How would I express that? So while you are singing what's on the page, how would Alexandria, you know, emote? And bring yourself into that,
yeah.
You know, because I feel like you have so much to offer, we all do, and that's the beauty of being an artist. You can really, truly make it your own.
Si, si, je vole andare, e se la cosa
I felt you. I felt you on that. Yeah, I have goosebumps. I have goosebumps, actually. I just want to do that, yeah. The ending one more time. Your high notes are just so glorious, and I feel like you can go further.
Okay.
So on the pietà, it's like, please, pity. So can you try to start that in a smaller space and then Pietà. And Lester is amazing, and he'll be with you on those Bapo Pietas. You don't have to do that in time. And when you do this with orchestra, they will also be there with you.
Okay.
So yeah, because you're weeping, it's like Bapo Pietà, Pietà. Now, can you say Pietà?
Pietà.
Yeah, it's actually Pietà.
Pietà.
Yeah, but what you were singing was more of Pietà, like it just wasn't that Italian.
Okay.
Chiaro. We want the chiaro and the scuro. So we need just more of that. Right. So in your mind, and then I have to do this too because I have a naturally dark voice, but it's just like over exaggerate it in your mind, and then it'll probably be right.
Okay, cool.
And very clear. That oddio was amazing. I want to hear that again.
Si, si,
So how did you feel about that? I mean, how are you feeling so far?
So far, I feel free. I feel more connected.
Good.
With that, using what you were saying, using my double T's and my arno, I felt like all of my vowels were
more aligned.
More aligned, yeah.
Good. Oh, good, good, good. Yeah. And the last, I mean, you have a fermata before the final, Babbo Pietà.
Yes.
Pietà. I actually, I feel like I used to not really pay attention to markings very often. And I think singers, sometimes we get caught up in like all the other things that we have to pay attention to that we kind of ignore marking sometimes, but like they're there for a reason. So you can just use that more.
Okay.
It's like after she cries to him, Babbo Pietà, Oh, and also on that Pietà, you can take, if you need, you can take a little a breath.
Yes.
But if it's easier for you to set up and keep going, then that's okay. But it would be interesting.
Yes, I'll try it.
Yeah. Okay, wait, let's go back and try it then. Oddio, maybe?
Yes.
And vibrate that. Even though it's an eighth note, you can still connect it.
Connecting, yes.
Yes. Oh my gosh. Doesn't that feel good? I mean, you have such a big, gorgeous voice. Let us have it. And you just did. I personally love that. And there, I don't think that Puccini or anyone conducting would mind that time. Because it makes it real.
Yeah. Right in this moment, la retta.
Exactly. And also your voice just blossoms up there. So don't cut us short. Yeah. Gorgeous. Do you have any questions?
I was actually, when practicing, I wanted to know your take on breathing in the shape of the vowel. So sometimes you're planning, when you're setting up the breath too before. What's your take on making sure that even though like there's time and you're making sure you're breathing in the shape of the vowel, what do you do to make sure that you know that, okay, boom.
Yeah, I mean, that is an amazing point that you bring up. Definitely visualizing it. I do a lot of visualization.
Okay.
But breathing in the shape, in the form of the vowel is very important. And it's something that I don't think about so much anymore because now it's just
natural
there. But it is super important because it sets up the rest of the phrase, you know? And the goal is for everything we sing to be as legato as possible, even if we have, you know, coloratura or staccato markings. Like, there has to be binding. And when you breathe into the shape of the vowel, that is automatically going to set you up. Yes.
Okay.
In a good way. So you are completely on track with that thinking.
Awesome.
Keep doing that. what else about that? I mean, something that I've recently been paying a lot of attention to is when I have a long note on a vowel, not doing some weird stuff. Along the way.
Yeah.
Like keeping that. And that also has a lot to do with your engagement of your breath, to just keep the air going and not do anything here.
Okay.
Yeah, that's just another addition to that thought. Great question. Yeah, I love that. Lester, beautiful playing. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous.
Thank you.
And thank you so much.
Thank you for having
it's
me.
So it's so nice to be live with you. I'm so happy that I could be with you live and hear your gorgeous voice and your overtones in this beautiful synagogue.
Yes.
Brava.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Oh.